Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Retribution Paladin Guide for World of Warcraft Wrath of the Lich King 3.3.5 on Warmane's Icecrown server. Today we'll take a detailed look at the Retribution specialization for the Paladin class. I have split this guide up into 7 little steps. As for the intro, allow me to add a little bit of credibility to this list by bragging about all of my achievements. So yeah, if you can match that kind of curriculum vitae and think that you know something that I don't, feel free to put it in the comment section down below. Knowledge is understanding that wisdom should be shared. Someone important probably said that at some point. With that little disclaimer out of the way, let us talk about the basic of basics, the talent tree. And oh boy, for Retribution Paladin, you almost cannot go wrong. This is pretty much universally considered the best Retribution talent tree for 3.3.5 PvE raiding. Alternatively, you could take a Divine Sacrifice build that would look something like this. There isn't a lot to talk about in the talent tree. I do want to explain which passive and which active buffs you as a Retribution Paladin is going to give to the raid. We have Swift Retribution. This grants the entire raid 3% haste. There's also Judgment of the Wise. This will grant ourselves 25% of our base mana whenever we hit a judgment. Additionally, it will give up to 10 raid members 3% mana over 15 seconds in replenishment. Not last and not least either, Heart of the Crusader will add 3% additional crit chance on our judgment target. On top of that, Sanctified Retribution will give all of our friendly targets within range of any of our auras a 3% damage increase. Knowing what buffs you give is important when you are making a raid. Knowing which buffs stack and which don't, which you will need and which you can get. Armed with that knowledge, you can build a proper raiding setup. Alright, that's it for the talents, now for the glyphs. There is no leeway when it comes to glyphs, you're going to want these three major glyphs. For the miners, I would suggest Lay on Hands and Sense Undead. The last one can be filled to your heart's content. I will not discuss gearing in length, but there are some stats that we need to get in order to go beast mode on Retribution Paladin. Obviously, we want to start with hit rating and expertise. Like I love to say, if you don't hit your target, you are not doing any damage. We will need 8% hit rating. This is pretty easy to get, especially if you have Tiny Abomination in a jar on Heroic. Keep in mind that a Draenei can provide you with 1% hit rating. If you happen to be a Horde and you have no access to this marvelous Draenei buff, you could always consider logging into warmane.com and faction swapping to the better faction. Now that our hit rating is situated at a firm 8%, we will want 26 expertise. The Glyph of Vengeance can help you out greatly with achieving this goal. Do you happen to have too much expertise because of shitty gearing gear? Swap Glyph of Vengeance with Glyph of Exorcism for an immediate DPS increase. That's it for stats in this video. Retribution Paladin is super easy and extremely linear to gear and prioritize stats on. So, you just want to cap out your hit rating and your expertise and then stack as much strength as you can. Just stack it on there. Keep in mind that you're gonna want about 700 to 800 agility with full raid buffs on. This is Blessing of Kings, Gift of the Wild from a Druid, a Strength of the Earth Totem from an Enhancement Shaman, or a Horn of Winter from a Death Knight. Chapter 2, Macros. There aren't a whole lot that are super crucial. One that has recently become more popular and with good reason is the Chaos Bane Reset macro. This is a Shadowmourne specific macro. What it effectively does is that it turns off your Shadowmourne's strength proc, allowing it to proc more often, which will result in more damage. It can be quite significant with the right RNG, and we all know that that is a big part of endgame raiding. If you macro Divine Shield with a nice cancel aura in the second line of the macro like this, you can use it like a Shadow Priest would use Dispersion. Wait for the big damage to happen, shield up, shield down, left right BA start for easy damage. A few other macros that I use, but depending on your gameplay style, you might not want to use them. These macros will allow you to use mouse over on your raid frames. And of course, for maximum DPS, you have a mouse over Hand of Reckoning macro. This is extremely useful in fights like the Lich Kings. You can easily taunt Valkyrs and deal big damage to them. Just be careful with that one, you do not want the boss to delete you. Do you know any macros for Retribution Paladin that I've left out? Let me know in the comment section down below. Chapter 3. The Pusser, Rotation, Priority, List, Picker, whatever, Hit Buttons, Smash the Face with the Keyboard. What the hacking bamboozled doggo is that chapter name of up? Yeah, well, I don't know either. I guess we can call it a priority list because a rotation is just not the right way to name it. Because of the tier 10, 2 set bonus, all of our melee attacks or attacks counted as melee attacks such as Crusader Strike have a 40% chance to reset Divine Storm, our second hardest hitting spell in a single target situation. And that is how we will look at this priority list, which spell hits the hardest. That is the dominating criteria when it comes to making a judgment call on what spell to use next. Several other criteria are raid tactics, low mana, and setting up the bomb. Now that you're a little bit more familiar with my Retribution Paladin terminology, I will explain what setting up the bomb means. As you might have noticed in this video so far, my burst rotation is very specific, yet malleable because of the Divine Storm resets. What it comes down to is that you will want Engineering Gloves and the Haste Potion to stack up Seal of Vengeance to 5 stacks before you hit the second Judgment. So in practice it will look something like this. The Avenging Wrath is cast before the second Judgment is cast. After the opening Ooga Booga, we will just want to stick to the priority list of Divine Plea if your mana is lower than 25% in general, or if it's lower than 50% on the Lich King pre-third phase. So if you're still in the second phase, get that Divine Plea up. Judgment, Divine Storm, Crusader Strike because it can reset Divine Storm, Consecration, Exorcism, remember to only use it with Art of War, Holy Wrath if the target is undead. Make sure you prioritize higher if it's like more than 10 mobs, but keep the stun for timers like Precious Adds when he decimates. Hand of Salvation, Sacred Shield on yourself or a tank if there is no Holy Paladin and Prot Paladin. Flash of Light, only with Art of War obviously, on either yourself, a tank or maybe even a dying teammate. Now obviously here is where I gotta point out. Retribution Paladin is easy to play, but very, very hard to master. RNG is always going to be RNG, but with proper education, you won't be a mother-something fool. And that is what Retribution Paladin comes down to. Practicing the burst rotation and understanding how to fill in as many global cooldowns as possible. Chapter 4. Ugh, Tility. We've arrived at probably my least favorite chapter in this guide. And that is for the simple reason of I am DPSing, bother the other 3 paladins, like literally, why are you making me use G-Bok on this numbnut who has just died, it's like not even my fault, and like honestly, let the protection paladin buff, I'm DPSing, what the fuck. That is not the right mentality to have when you are playing a retribution paladin, because of their numerous awesome utility spells. Like I said in the previous chapter to this one, you should try to fill all of your global cooldowns. Doing this, however, will not allow a lot of space for utility spells. And paladins have a lot of them. Just take a look above your default UI's action bar. 7 spells with their own unique application across several different fights. Luckily, you preemptively set the right aura, so you might only have to swap it in some fights, but even then it's not that big of a deal. Besides the auras, we have obviously Aura Mastery. Aura on steroids, enough said. There are the passive raid buffs that we have talked about in the intro section, but besides that we have Blessing of Kings, Wisdom and Might. You'll have to apply these to everyone before a boss is pulled, and remember to rebuff the people who have died. Death is not the end with a proper rebuff. Bless You is not all that we paladins can do. Oh no, good sir or ma'am or frog. We have healing. Judgment of Light, the instant flashes of light, which are gonna allow you to help out. For fuck's sake, why did you have to subscribe? Now I have to re-record it. We have got healing, Judgment of Light, and the instant flashes of light will allow you to help out a little bit with the healing. I have actually healed Ruby Sanctum 10-man normal as a Retribution Paladin. Granted that our tank was a Blood Death Knight, so he pretty much healed himself. My point is, you have healing, Judgment of Light, instant flashes of light with a heal over time on crit, Sacred Shield which is absolutely broken in fights with small yet constant area of effect damage, and of course, Lay on Hands with also a heal over time on crit. Use them as you would any of your hands. Hand of Freedom, Sacrifice, Salvation and Protection are all spells capable of saving the raid in specific circumstances. Using them wisely will distinguish a proper paladin from a poor man's paladin. As is using your stuns in several fights, such as Lady Deathwhisperer Heroic, the raid might need a stun or a repentance a little bit more than your damage. If you did get engineering for the haste gloves, keep in mind that you can get the belt bomb on top of the blacksmithing belt buckle as well. Seal of Justice. My. Aren't you a special little thing, aren't you, Seal of Justice? Sadly, for Retribution Paladin, I have never found a use for this. You just give up too much damage for the CC to be worth it. On a Protection Paladin, however, it can be amazing against the Lich King Valkyrs, especially if you are in a pickle and you're gonna need some additional CC on the Valkyrs. More shall we find in our taunts. We've got one single target taunt that is the only taunt in the game with damage, hint hint. And a 3-person semi-area of effect taunt. These can be used in rapid but perfect succession to taunt an enemy for a full 12 seconds. After that, it will become taunt immune. As for crowd control, we have got Hammer of Justice, a powerful 6-second stun that you know and hate or love from PvP. We also have Repentance, fiercely overpowered when leveling, but in endgame raiding it is more of an interrupt or an in-combat sap if anything. Since we are the Harbringers of Light and Vengeance, we also have spells specifically against the hordes of the undead. Holy Wrath will stun and damage any nearby undead target. Turn Evil has probably the least use in the entirety of ICC, but you can still get some good mileage out of it if you use it on VDW Encounter. Whether that be on a mage or a flamey bony boy to interrupt the cast, or maybe even the Abomination to help the tank kite, either application is useful. And that brings us to our final crowd control ability. Judgment of Justice. Now let me finish my sentence before you go nuts and tell me that this isn't technically a CC spell, because in my opinion it totally is. It caps the target movement speed to 100%, allowing you to, with a movement speed modifier such as Pursuit of Justice, to permanently outrun the enemy. This is especially useful on those fat Abomination boys in VDW, as it doesn't tend to work on bosses anymore. You know what I'm referring to. Molten. Dear lord. That is quite a bit of utility, honestly. It is like several action bars full. And I thought Retribution Paladin was like a noob 3-button class. What? Let's see here. Engineering and haste potion until 5 stacks of Seal of Vengeance, then blow up the bomb. I said it already. Obviously Nitro Boosts. Yes, there is an S in there. Are a great tool to keep DPSing in a tight situation. Probably said it as well. Using Aura Mastery, nope, already said it. Let's see. Ah, here's one. With this macro, your Divine Storm will reset Chaos Bane automatically.
You dumb fuck, stop repeating yourself.
What?
You dumb fuck, stop repeating yourself.
Well, I don't know. Here is a criteria and then a list of shit that you should taunt because they don't kill you immediately if they do. Alright, so the criteria is basically this. Any trash mob that needs to die and possesses no immediate threat to your life. For example, do not taunt a huge ass Abomination. In Warcraft 3, he would have been a strength character. But you can go ahead and taunt a small scientist. In Warcraft 3, he would be considered an intellect character. You catching my drift? Now here's the list of shit you wanna taunt. Lord Merugar's Boner, Lady Deathwhisperer's first phase when she has a mana shield and is being an absolute little bitch. Axe throwers on gunship battle if you care about your DPS there. Bloodbeast if they get stunned and nuked and present no threat to you. Bloodbeast if they present significant threat to the ranged, help them kite. Anything in VDW, just do not die. The ice cubes on Syndragosa. The kinetic bombs in Bloodprince Council. Anything in the Lich King fight that isn't the Lich King, a raging spirit, a shambling horror, or a ghoul with necrotic plague. The Lich King when he is casting Fury of Frostmourne or in the last 10% HP roleplay phase if you still care about your DPS there. Another thing that you need to learn is the radius of your spells, more specifically Divine Storm. It is actually possible to kill wicked spirits inside of the Frostmourne chamber with Divine Storm without being hit. Just try practicing that in a Bane before you try it in an LOD. Chapter 6. I forgot a name. Okay. We're setting it up. We are so setting it up.
The bomb has been planted.
Okay, now let's go, let's push it. Oh man, oh by god, that man has been broken in half, that man has been split in half. Oh shit! The sound created by the holy bomb was in fact so devastating that my audio arts director Elun Musica internally exploded and died on the spot. Rest in peace, audio arts director. He was also a time traveler. That is all I have on Retribution Paladin for 3.3.5. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you have learned something, but more importantly, I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please consider hitting that like button, subscribing, tuning into my streams, and maybe even joining my Discord. I hope you are having a wonderful day, a wonderful evening, a wonderful night, and I'll be out.